Yes, in this video, we are going to see about the stacks and subroutines in 8085. So, before going to subroutine, first we'll see the operations on stack. Already in data structure, you have studied about stack. Stack is nothing but a LIFO structure, last in, first out. So, whichever you push, the data you'll be keep on pushing, the topmost data will, the one will be, that is the latest data, the is the one which you will be popped from the stack. So this is the organization of the stack. Now we are going to see how it is carried over in microprocessor. So in microprocessor, we have the RAM, random access memory, that is main memory. In that, it has, you can have the you can treat the memory as a stack. So it is an area, stack is an area of RAM or main memory. It is identified by the programmer for temporary storage of information. So for example, if you take this as a memory, RAM. So here the memory starts 00002, it is considered 4F. We write programs from here and the stack grows from bottom. So you can assign the lowermost as the stack pointer, that is address of the stack. And then whatever you push, it grows like that. When you push one value, it will be the stack pointer moves here. Then when you push another one, the stack pointer moves like, and so on. So the stack grows upwards, whereas our program grows downwards. So you can actually initialize the stack pointer here somewhere in the middle. But care has to be taken that because our programs grows downward and the stack grows upwards, both should, the stack should not override the user's program, so that the user programs will be overwritten by the content of the stack and the program is last. So in order to avoid that, we always initialize the stack to be the end of the memory, and then we keep the increase the stack pointer accordingly. So the stack is a LIFO structure, that is last in, first out, and the stack grows backwards. That's what just now I have explained. In other words, the programmer defines the bottom of the stack, as I said, and the stack grows up in order to reducing the address range. Given that the stack grows backwards into memory, it is customary to place the bottom of the stack at the end of the memory to keep it as far away from the user programs. Because when it keeps growing, say for example, I am keeping the stack pointer to be here. You can keep the stack pointer anyway, anywhere in the memory location. But when we keep the stack pointer, as it grows upwards, what happens? Our user program grows downwards. So at some point they may overlap. The stack will overwrite the user program. So in order to avoid that, it is better to make a practice to keep the stack as the end of the memory. So let us see the syntax of how to initialize the stack pointer. So we have the instruction called load LXI, that is immediate the register pair. So SP is a 16-bit register. So naturally for 16-bit register loading, you go for this LXI. X is for 16-bit register, and we are storing the memory location in the stack pointer. So here, stack pointer, here any 16-bit register, but here what is given is at the end of the memory location of 8085 is given here. So after execution of this statement, stack pointer will have this memory location. So now it is pointing to here. Then the size of the stack is limited only by the available memory. Yes. So how much memory you have, here you may have 16 GB, you may have 64 GB. Since we are keeping the stack to point to the end, so as long as how much memory the system, the microprocessor is giving, that much size the stack can have. So 8085, it provides, you know, here we have initialized the stack pointer, but to place the data in the stack and remove the data from the stack, we have two exclusive statements called push and pop. So push is used to push the data into the stack and pop is used to pop the information, take the information from the stack. So here, and they work, push and pop work with the register pair only. Okay, so data, we'll see, in short, we will see how it works. database in the register pass of the microprocessor can be stored. As it works, push and pop works with the register pair, the data in both the register, that is two registers, okay, BC, DE, HL. So that pair will be, when you issue a push operation, then that register pair, both the data will be pushed into the stack. When you pop, it also pops as a next two locations. That is, the top two locations will be popped, and top two locations, it will be, the data will be pushed. So when you issue your push operation, it automatically do two increments. There is no need to increment the stack pointer. When you give a push and pop, automatically the stack pointer will be incremented or decremented by two. So since we are pushing the data, when we push the data, the stack pointer will be incremented. As I already told you, it grows upwards. So initially the stack pointer is here. When you push a register pair, the stack pointer is incremented by two, because in the first location, the higher order bit will be stored, and in the second location, lower order bit will be stored, as it is a 16 bit. So now we'll see how it works. So the stack is used by both the programmer and microprocessor. The programmer can use register pair to push and pop data to and from the stack. The microprocessor uses stack during subroutines to store the content of the program counter. Now we already see this is the how the registers are arranged. So here this is the program counter, which is a 16 bit, and stack pointer is another 16 bit. This is where we initialize, that is, we give the address location of the stack pointer. As address is a 16 bit, here also the register is a 16 bit register. Then we have the register pair. So when you use together, we can use it as a 16 bit HL, DE, BC, and then accumulator and flag register. This also you can use it as a 16 bit, but you cannot, this can be used as a 16 bit registers. Okay, now we'll see the syntax. First, initially you have to initialize the stack pointer with a 16 bit memory location, then push RP. RP is register pair. So this is a common syntax. Then we can use push B. When I say push B, both B and C will be pushed. Then push D means D and E, H means HL, and then push PSW is program status word, which is nothing but accumulator along with the flag register. So it is called program status word. Then at same way, pop register pair. This is a general syntax. So you can have pop B, D, H, and pop PSW. So we'll see the push instruction. Push B, we'll see one instruction, all the others will act similarly. So push B, it is a 1 byte instruction. Okay, so decrement, what it will do when you push the data, let us imagine already we have initialized to SP. Then when you push data, say for example BC register, push B means BC register will be pushed. First higher order data will be pushed, and then the stack pointer will be incremented, and the lower order bit will be pushed. So it is not, you don't explicitly say increment the stack pointer. Only initialization with the LXI is done. After that, the push instruction itself will increment, it is not actually increment, decrement, because FF, then it becomes FE and then FD. As it grows upwards, it will be decrementing. So the stack pointer is decremented now by two. Okay, so at first RAM, it will be placing the higher order bit, that is B registers will be placed first and then C. So when you say it is a 16 bit, you call this as a higher order bit and this as a lower order bit. So higher order data is placed first and then the lower order data. So decrement SP, copy the contents of the B register to the memory location pointed by SP first, and then decrement SP again, another one is done. Decrement is done, then copy the contents of C. So just one push B will do two decrement. The same way, pop instruction will do two increment. So here when I say for example, here the stack pointer is there. After this execution, let us consider the stack pointer will be here. Now when you issue a pop D, let us imagine some other pop D. We give pop D. Now what happens? The topmost element will be placed in E. That is, this is a register pair DE. So here itself we have given D. So it will take that pair only. So this topmost element will be placed at the lower order bit, which is nothing but here E register. And the next automatically it will be incremented. From D it is incremented to E. And now SP points here. And then the data is placed. And then again it will be automatically decremented. So two increments are done. Initially it will be that. This one increment and another increment. So it will do two increment and pop the value and place values in the respective register given in the pop instruction. So operation of the stack during pushing, the stack operates in a decrement memory location, then store stack. The stack pointer is decremented first, then the information is placed on the S. That's what we are doing. First it is decremented and then it is placed on the data is placed. Okay. During popping, the stack operates in a use then increment. Yes. Here first it is placed and then it is incremented. Then it is again placed on the respective register and then it is incremented. So that is what given here. So the during popping, the stack operates in a use then increment memory location state. The information is retrieved from the top of the stack and then the pointer is incremented. The SP pointer always points to the stack pointer is always point to the top of the stack. Next we will see one more thing. We have seen B, C, D. So you can, it can be, it'll be applied to push B, push D, push E. It's a register pair. One more thing we have seen, push PSW. Exclusively we have that PSW. So when you give the PSW, accumulator and the flag bit or transferred, pushed to the stack pointer, as well as when you issue pop PSW, the information is popped and placed in the accumulator and the flag register respectively. We'll see the operation here. It is also a 1-byte instruction. The same way how we have seen in the push and pop, same way it works. Here, if you see that, see push PSW. So the accumulator value is placed first and then the flag registers. So the stack pointer is was initially here, then it is decremented and the data is placed, and again it is decremented and the data is placed. Why I say decrement? Because it grows upwards. So here there is a memory decrement. Then pop. Pop is, it becomes increment of the stack. It grow because you are, as you are pushing, as you are popping, the stack pointer goes down. So here pop PSW, copy the contents of the memory location pointed to by the SP. So whatever it is, top pointer is pointing, that will be popped and placed in the flag register. And then the next data is also popped and placed in the accumulator. So it works at a time two increment or two decrement. So LIFO. So already we have seen stack works in using the LIFO, that is last in first out. And because of this, it follows the order strict. So what happens if you give push B, push D, you have to pop it in this decreasing, the same order, reverse order, or else it doesn't know, it just pop it and whatever the register you have, that will be transferred. Say for example, here push B, push D, you have to give the same order, pop D and pop B. Suppose you change it as pop B here and pop D, what happens? This D and E pair will be popped and placed in BC, and then BC, that is what push, that will be placed and placed in the D. If you reverse this order, say for example, we'll see with an example here, this small program, that is where stack pointer is initialized 2099. So here it is initialized. So now the memory, this is the memory, how it looks. So 2099, first initially the stack pointer is pointing. Then LXIH 4252. Now it is stored already. After executing the statement, H and L pair will have this value. Now you execute a statement called push H. So when you give push H, what happens? The first H will be pushed and then L will be pushed. So now it is decremented, 99 to 98 and then 97. Here we paste the H register and L register value. Okay, now when you pop it, what happens? It pops. Now we have given up some delay counter, some program coding is there. Then somewhere we have given poppage. When we give poppage, the top value will be, since we have given HL pair, so the top value is popped and placed in L, and top, the next value is popped and placed in H. This is what we have seen. Now we see if we reverse. That's what I said. If you reverse the order, what will happen? Now, if you change the order, what will happen? Initially, see here, it's another example. Stack pointer is made to point to 2400 memory location. Then HL will consist of 2150. Then B consists of 2280. We have stored these values. Then some value is moved from memory location to, that is from 2150. When I say M, it points to HL per only. So from the memory location 2150, whatever is that will be moved to accumulator. Data is moved. Okay, this is the situation. Then push H. Push H, what will happen? This 2150 is pushed into the stack. Then push B. After this value is pushed. Then push PSW. This value is also put. But here what we have done, it's taken in the same order. This is okay. So when you give pop PSW, the correct accumulator value on flag registers are part. But here, instead of pop B, because we have to give in the same order, I said. So pop B, we have given pop H. Now what happens? After execution of the statement, H will consist of, because push B is the latest. So latest only will be published. Already PSW is the latest. That is popped and placed in the respective register correctly. Now we have issued pop H. Now what happens? B is the value placed. So 22 and 80 will be popped. And then the HL pair will be replaced with 2280. I'll show you that. See here. This is a stack pointer content. That is these three lines we are seeing here. So stack contents after execution of the push instructions. So push H, here this is the stack pointer, initially 2400. Then that is what we have initialized here, 2400. Okay, so 2400. Then when you issue a push H, it will be incremented by 2. Okay, so in the first increment, the value HL pair is, what is the HL pair value? It is nothing but 2150. So first H is pushed and then L is pushed. So here we have 21 and 50. Then what we have done? Push B. Push B in the next two locations. So the stack pointer is again decremented by 2. So 22 and 80. That is what here we find in B. Okay. Then flag registers. First accumulator and then flag register. So this is how the data is placed. So after the three push operations, now we'll see the pop operations. When you say pop PSW, it correctly pops because these two values are popped and placed in the respective accumulator and flag register. Now pop H is given. So what happens? Now the stack pointer is now pointing here. Okay, after popping this pop PSW, now it is pointing here. So the 80 is placed in, because we have given H. So 80 is placed in L and 22 is placed in H. And then stack pointer is pointing here. Now 50 is pop B we have given. So 50 is popped and placed in C and 21 is popped and placed in C. Now if you say it is nothing but exchanging of registers. What has been done here is exchanging of information. H data is moved to B and B data is moved to H. Yeah, same way L register is shifted to C and C is moved to L. So likewise also you execute exchange. If I want to exchange the data between registers, we can change the, we can push it like that. But care has, if I don't want this thing to be done, I want the same data to be passed to HL and same data to be in BC, then care has to be taken. I should not reverse like that. So after PSW, I have to give pop B, then pop H. Then only you can retain the whole data of a respective register, or else this is what happens. Okay. We'll see the application of this push and pop, how whether it affects the flag registers or not in the next video.